Among various regional analgesia option for the knee surgery from center to periphery, today we will discuss about femoral triangle block, adductor canal block, dual subsartorial block, high volume proximal adductor canal block, infiltration between popliteal artery and capsule of knee joint, IPAC block, and local infiltration analgesia, which is called as LIA block. These blocks are considered as a motor sparing block for the knee joint surgery, except HIPAC block, which is described for below knee surgeries. So before we begin, we should know the purpose of each block, whether they are providing analgesia for the anterior knee or posterior knee or both. For that, knowledge of complex innervation of the knee joint is very much important. These innervations include innervations of dermatomes, osteotomes, myotomes, and anterior and posterior capsules. All these nerves, before supplying the knee joint, they form three different plexuses. Peripatellar plexus, which lies anteriorly over the knee joint, it supplies skin around the patella and anterior capsule, whereas subsartorial plexus lies over the medial aspect of the thigh and it supplies anterior medial knee as well as anterior capsule, and posterior or popliteal plexus, it lies over the posterior aspect, it supplies all the intra-articular structures and posterior capsule. To understand the blocks at the level of the thigh, we need to understand two prominent landmarks over the thigh. One is femoral triangle and one is adductor canal. We should differentiate the territories of the femoral triangle and adductor canal in the region of the thigh. It is differentiated or it is demarcated by apex of the femoral triangle. Here you can see the apex of the femoral triangle is formed by the intersection point. Here it is B of medial border of adductor longus and medial border of sartorius. So area above the B or area above the apex of the femoral triangle is considered as a femoral triangle area, and area below the apex of the femoral triangle under the sartorius is considered as adductor canal area. Second prominent landmark is adductor canal. The adductor canal is nothing but the musculoaponeurotic tunnel lying over the medial aspect of the thigh under the sartorius. It is triangular in cross section. It is bounded anterolaterally by the vastus medialis muscle, posteriorly by the adductor longus muscle, and in the proximal part, an adductor magnus muscle in the distal part. And medially, it is bounded by a fibrous connective tissue or the fascia, which is known as vasoadductor membrane. If you see here properly, the saphenous nerve lies inside the adductor canal, whereas nerve to vastus medialis lies outside adductor canal and having a separate facial sheath. So this is the fibrous connective tissue, which is known as vasoadductor membranes, because it connects vastus medialis muscle with the adductor muscles. It is also very important to know the sonoanatomy at various level of the thigh, and you need to demarcate the area of the femoral triangle as well as adductor canal by identifying the apex of the femoral triangle. If you see in this figure, the C demonstrates the apex of the femoral triangle, where you can see the medial border of sartorius and medial border of adductor longus are overlying one another, and they form a sign of three, which is also called as kissing sign. So area above C is considered as a femoral triangle, and area below C or distal to the C will be considered as an adductor canal. Presence of vasoadductor membrane, here it is demarcated by the green line, all the area of the adductor canal, is the peculiarity of the adductor canal, because of which the sartorius lower border becomes or it appears bilayer in the adductor canal region.